Hey guys, I hope you're all doing really well. I thought I would sit down today and talk a little bit about some outfit ideas for Bali or other kind of tropical destinations you might have, or just kind of summer in general, because I did go to Bali a couple of weeks ago. If you haven't seen the vlog, I'll link it down below. And I kind of went there with the intention of filming a week of outfits, I think it's called, something like that, something lookbook, week of outfits, something like that over there, because I specifically bought some clothing and I put together really cute outfits and I did wear all of them. I just didn't manage to film them. I think it was just nice for me to kind of take a break from work a little bit besides vlogging and just hang out with the girls and just have a fun girls trip. And I still wanted to do this video though, so even though I didn't manage to film them in Bali, I still wanted to show you guys the outfits and some of the things that I picked up because I really liked them and I thought it might be helpful if you are going on holiday somewhere anytime this year, or if you are in Australia. It's still pretty warm. I think it's still appropriate to wear summer outfits. And it is March, so a lot of places in the world are going into summer soonish, kind of. So I just really wanted to do this video. And I sat down, I've got a pile of clothes next to me. I thought I would just talk you guys through the outfits that I wore, through some of my favorite outfits. I'll show you guys photos, but I'll also try on the clothing and kind of include try on clips like I do when I do hauls. So yeah, let's get into it. And I think I'm gonna start off with the very first outfit that I wore on the first night when we got there. We went to El Cabron, which was really fun, would recommend. And I wore this little mini skirt. This is a leopard denim skirt. I got this on Princess Polly and it's by Motel. By the way, some of these items I've had for a while, so if they aren't available anymore, I will try to find alternative options for you guys, but I'll link everything down below. Anyway, so I wore this skirt. This is in a size medium. It's just a cute little leopard skirt, denim material. Then I wore this little bikini top. This is from Myra Swim. I believe that's how it's announced. They have the best swimwear, some of the best swimmers I've ever had. I bought two bikinis just for the trip and I'm so glad that I did it. So I got this chocolate, yeah, I would say this is a chocolate colored top. Is so comfortable, so flattering. The fabric is just amazing. It's got a gold kind of buckle at the back. The quality is really, really good. Definitely worth investing. But anyway, so I wore this with a leopard skirt. And then over the top, I wore this top from Glaçons. And this is just like a white little crochet top. And it's long sleeve. It's really pretty. And obviously you can kind of see the bikini top through this, which is why I love it. And I think these types of tops are so perfect if you are at the beach, for example, just in a bikini or swimsuit, but then you want to go into a bar or a restaurant and you want to go there straight away, but you kind of just want to cover up a little bit, which that's what I like doing. I don't really like going into a restaurant in my just bathers. I think these types of tops are just so perfect because you can throw them over your bikini and it looks really cute. I know they also have dresses like this. I didn't have one with me in Bali. I don't think I have one at the moment, but I used to have a dress like this and that was really cute as well. So I love this first look. And then I think on the second day, I wore these shorts that I got at General Pants. Where are you? There we go. So these are from Alice and the Eve and they've just been in the wash, so they're a little bit crinkled. But I got these in a size medium and they're just that kind of nice linen short. I really like this color. I just wanted some shorts that weren't tight because basically when it's hot, I will wear denim shorts a lot. But I don't actually think they're the best thing to wear when it is really warm. I wanted to get some shorts that are more flowy and just more breathable. And these were so, so comfortable. These were definitely one of the things that I loved wearing most in Bali because when we were there, it was so humid and so hot and I sweat a lot and very easily. So these shorts were definitely a piece that I loved wearing there. They were so comfortable and so breathable and I probably had the least amount of sweat running down my butt in these, so that was good. But I wore these shorts and then the chocolate bikini top again from Myra Swim. And then over the top, I bought this dress from Beckenbridge. I'm pretty sure it's meant to be a dress, but I actually ended up wearing it as a jacket. So it's this kind of safari vibe dress with the buttons and it's got these little pockets and I decided to just wear this open and it looked so good. And I actually wore this with a bunch of different things, so I'll keep showing you guys different options to wear with this, but I'm so glad that I bought this. I wasn't sure, I almost didn't buy this because it was really expensive, but I'm actually so glad I did. It was such a good investment piece because I've been layering it over everything, even back home, just with a white tank top like this and denim shorts, actually with what I'm wearing. I will just throw this over the top and it looks so good, and it looks like a whole look, like it's so put together, but it was really easy and it's super comfortable as well. I'm obsessed with this. Yeah, so that's what I wore to breakfast on the first proper day, and then after that we went to Omnia Beach Club, which was insane. Could probably spend a month straight there just lying on a sunbed and drinking cocktails and eating food and swimming in the pool. It was absolutely incredible. If you ever have a chance to go, it was definitely a highlight for me of the trip. And I wore this little blue dress. I got this at General Pants as well. This is from Alice in the Eve. Again, I got it in a size medium. And what I loved about this is the really thin straps and then the open back as well. I thought it was really beautiful. I did wear a bikini top underneath this, just a black one. I got this one years and years ago, like 5-6 years ago, and I have no idea what brand this is, but it probably doesn't exist anymore. But I'll try to find a similar option for you. So it was just a basic kind of black top that I wore underneath, just because with this dress I found that the front part is quite low. Like, I'm not sure how else you're meant to wear this. I feel like you have to wear something underneath. I probably could have also tied a knot in the string just at the top, and then that would have kind of solved the issue as well. But I just wore it with a bikini top underneath and I thought it was really cute. So I really love this as well. Again, really nice and flowy. I don't know what material this is. I wouldn't say linen. I think it's just cotton. It is double lined, but it wasn't too hot or anything, just because it's just a short dress with an open back, and it was really nice and flowy and so beautiful, I think. And I love, love, love this color. I'll show you guys a photo that we took in front of the kind of view from Omnia, and it looked so beautiful. If I could go back there right now, take me. The next day we got settled into our next villa, and then we went out to drinks and dinner with a bunch of friends. And I actually wore this little crop top that I bought on ASOS. If you guys watch my latest ASOS haul, sorry, then you would have seen this. It's from Free People, but I got it via ASOS. It's this beautiful little yellow floral bralette. Super cute. And I wore this with the denim shorts that I'm wearing right now. These are by the A brand. Got these on Princess Polly. I'll link everything down below again. And I wore these two together with, again, the Beckenbridge dress that I turned into a jacket over the top, and it was really cute, really comfortable. Yeah, we just went to dinner and drinks and I felt very cute. I think I wore some type of little heel with it, just like a very low comfortable heel. I don't think I got any photos in this just because it was at nighttime. We were just hanging out with friends, but again, a really cute outfit. And this material, look, this little top isn't the most breathable and it's obviously pretty tight as well, but it didn't bother me at all because it's so little fabric that's actually covering you, so I didn't feel like too hotness or anything. The next few outfits probably aren't gonna be in order because I honestly can't remember when I wore what, but then I wore this cute like white on white look. I'm not sure if I actually wore this out, but I wore this around our villa and we took some photos in it and I really, really liked them. So it's this little denim skirt by Camilla and Mark. I got this a couple months ago. It's obviously a white denim skirt. It's got a frayed hem. It's really nice. The quality is amazing. And I paired it with this top that I got from TU. Now it just looks like a strap, which essentially it is. So you tie it together kind of like this. I did a really hatchet job, but that's the idea. And I think you're meant to wear this at the front, but I actually wore it the other way around. So I had this at the back and then just the kind of towel strap on the front, and I thought it looked so good, especially together with the skirt, the white on white on tan skin. A dream. Really comfortable, and it's just such a vacation outfit. Like, where else would you wear this? And I love white on white. I've always loved all white outfits. I think it's never gonna go out of style. White is just such a classic color or non-color. Let's not start that argument. But I love white, as you can tell. So I really like this outfit. And we took really cute photos in front of these like green palm trees, and there was a white hammock and the walls were white, and then it was just the green palms kind of like making it a bit more interesting, and it was just, oh, it was like my perfect kind of aesthetic. It was so satisfying. So I love this outfit. And again, this is another great top to wear at the beach. So, so cute. And it's actually really comfortable because it feels like the softest towel you've ever felt. It's so, so nice. I believe they have this in different colors as well. And I think I'm definitely going to pick some more of these up when I go to Europe for the summer. So what was that? Okay. Calm down. But yeah, that was another little outfit. Then I think on the same day, I actually took photos in another outfit that involves this little skirt. So the same Camilla and Mark skirt, but I paired it with this lacy top. I need to find it. So I wore it with this top. This is vintage Dior, which I can't believe I actually found this. I got this in a little vintage store as well. Actually, I will link it down below. And obviously this top won't be available anymore because it's mine, but they have other really nice options, and this is so, so beautiful. I'm still so glad that I got my hands on this. It's just stunning. But I wore it with the white skirt. And then, I hope you guys aren't getting bored of this piece, the Beckenbridge dress slash jacket. I hope it's not annoying if I'm featuring items like multiple times, but that's actually something that I wanted to do more this year, is trying to find ways to wear one item in many different ways and trying to show you guys that as well, instead of always just buying more and more. And I think that's a really good approach to being a bit more sustainable as well, is to just really think about, what do I have in my closet and how can I really wear this in so many different ways before I actually buy something else. So yeah, I hope it's not annoying. Like, I hope you guys will enjoy that as well. And now I'm trying to think what else I wore. Oh, so I got these black pants. These are by Glassons again. They are these black kind of linen pants, and I really, really love these. I think I only wore these once though, because it was so hot the entire time. I was looking forward to wearing these so much, but it was almost too warm. So I did wear them once, and I actually bought a top to wear with these that I didn't end up wearing, but I'll show it to you guys anyways because it's really cute. So it's another Glassons top, and it is this little crochet lace-up top. Super, super cute. Again, over a bikini to die for. So nice. It kind of laces up at the front, if you guys can see that, and it's got this beautiful kind of crochet material. So my idea was to wear this together for like an all black look. Not sure why I didn't end up doing that, but I really wanted to show you guys the idea of this outfit and actually put it on, because I think it's really, really cute. So yeah, that was another one. So those were kind of all of the actual outfits that I put together that were really cute. Of course, I wore other things. On a lot of occasions, I just wear either the denim shorts or the flowy shorts with little tank tops. So for example, this one, this is again Glassons. They have such good basics at the moment. Just little tanks like this that are really comfortable to wear, and you can actually make them look really cute if you do style them with some jewelry like I'm doing right now, and then you just have some denim shorts on, some cute sneakers. Yeah, I don't know, it's like not the same level as the other stuff that I was showing you guys, where I was actually putting together and like I was planning the outfits, whereas this is more so stuff that I was just chucking on. So I took a bunch of little crops like this. I've got this white one from Brandy Melville. This one I took also, and then I also took a couple of t-shirts. So I took a few print t-shirts just to wear as well in case I wanted to be comfortable. I took this one. This is from Twin the label. I think I got this on Princess Polly. It's got this beautiful print and it says Bad at Love. I really like this. I love the kind of angel print on this, and it's just a nice oversized shirt, and I would just wear this tucked into my shorts. And again, it's an easy look. It's nothing revolutionary, but if you want to be comfortable, if it's warm and you know you don't feel like having a full-on outfit on every day, that's a great option. The second print shirt that I took, I bought at General Pants again. This is from Ksubi. And it's got this print, it says Vague, and again, I really like this. My friend Indy actually wore this a couple months ago, and I looked at it and I was like, I need to buy that, and then I finally did. So again, just wear this with shorts, and it's a super easy look. And I did want to show you guys the two Myra Swim bikinis that I got. So I already showed you guys the chocolate top, but I got matching bottoms as well. So I don't think I'm going to do a try on of these, but I just wanted to mention them again because they have really great bikinis. So I got these bottoms. They were really, really nice to wear, super comfortable. I just felt really good in them. So they're really nice and high-waisted. It's just a really flattering cut. And then I got the same bottoms in pink. And I don't know why I got this pink set, because you might be able to tell from this video and all my other videos that I love wearing a lot of neutral colors, bit of leopard here and there. Even this yellow is like out of the box for me, but then this is like something else. But it just really spoke to me and I thought it would be fun. And I got the same bottoms as the chocolate bottoms, just in pink. And then I got a matching top as well, but this one's different to the brown one. This is what it looks like. And when I'm just holding it up, it looks kind of boring, but this was so, so flattering on my body and it really held everything just up. I don't have a lot that needs to be held up, but it actually kind of gave it a little lift and just made it look really good. So I really, really love this top. If you guys need bikinis, this is not sponsored. I bought these with my own money. They were very expensive, but I just need to stress how amazing these bikinis are. Just putting it out there. In terms of like bags, I only took two bags. I took two of my vintage bags. So this one is a beautiful kind of tortoise shell handbag that I got a couple of weeks ago. It is vintage, so it won't be available anymore, but maybe I will be able to find a different kind of version of this. I took this one and then my vintage little Gucci. This is what that one looks like. I showed this to you guys in my vintage haul, I believe. And it's just a beautiful old Gucci bag with a really thick strap. And I decided to only take these two bags, and I didn't want to take any of my newer kind of luxury bags because I just don't think they like fit in with that island vibe. And I think also with like the linens and kind of the looks that I was wearing, it just wouldn't have worked. And yeah, I just feel like it's not tacky, but it just, yeah, I don't think it like really fits in with Bali and the whole scenery. But I thought the vintage bags worked really well over there, especially because of the colors, and they just kind of went with all of my outfits, which was nice. In terms of shoes, I didn't take a lot of shoes, but I will show you guys the ones that I took. I'm back with my shoes. So I had four pairs with me. I traveled in sneakers, in these ones, the Triple S, and yeah, I still wear these all the time. I got them a while ago and I still get questions about them sometimes, if I regret buying them and that kind of stuff, but I actually don't at all. I still love wearing these. So I traveled in these. I did wear them in Bali maybe once or twice, but again, it was kind of too hot. I do think it's still worth it to take some sneakers, especially for the plane and stuff. I just don't like traveling in like sandals. I don't know, it's for some reason that's weird to me. I always need to be traveling in sneakers, so I took these. And then I took two pairs of little heels. These are both from LMS. You guys might have seen these in my lookbook. So I took these ones that are kind of tortoise colored. And these are just really, really easy to wear. They're so, so comfortable. And obviously the heel is really small, so I don't think they look weird. Cause again, you're on an island. I don't think I would have worn like super high stilettos or something, but I think these look really kind of appropriate. And these looked really cute with a lot of the looks that I was wearing. And then I took my black ones as well. So I have these black ones and these have kind of like a snake leather effect, but it's obviously not snake. And yeah, I took these as well. I only wore these ones when we went to Omnia. I wore them with a blue dress, but it looked really cute, and especially because Omnia is a little bit fancier, this was perfect. So I do think it's worth taking some heels if you like wearing heels, but I wouldn't take really high ones. I mean, you can, but I don't think, I don't know, I just don't think, again, it works with the whole island style. And then I also took these Tony Bianco slides. These are really dirty because I've had them for years, and they're these kind of denim slides. They're not my most beautiful shoe, like I don't love these to death, but they are really comfortable, and especially when it's hot and you just want to slide into something and not wear a sneaker, not wear something with a heel, I do really like these. So I think that's worth as well, is just having a little slide that's really comfortable, that kind of goes with everything. And yeah, so I took these. So yeah, I guess that's kind of everything. I actually had such a good time filming this video. It just kind of feels like sitting down with a friend and going, this is what I'm packing on my trip. But it's, I mean, it's after my trip, but You guys know what I mean? I think it's always interesting to see what people take on trips. I always feel like my style changes so much depending on where I'm at, so I think it just makes for a really interesting concept. I hope you guys liked it as well. Please let me know. Also, do let me know if you guys would like me to do this video in a different way in the future, because I wish I would have filmed these outfits in Bali just to kind of add that to the video, like just so it's not like I'm just sitting at home and just shooting them at home. I think it could be a bit more interesting if I actually shoot them on the location that I'm at. So let me know if you guys would prefer that. And yeah, that's the end of the video. Hope you guys liked it. I hope you guys have a really good rest of your day, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.